So I turned on the news last Monday, and what I heard was, we need to prepare because the next 2 weeks are going to be the worst 2 weeks ever, that the number of sicknesses of COVID-19 is going to excel to an all-time high, and that the number of those who pass away from COVID-19 is going to be unbelievable. Prepare for the next 2 weeks of very high numbers. So last week it came and it left, and then this morning I turn on the news and guess what I saw, man? Prepare for the worst week you've ever seen of COVID-19. The number of people who are going to get sick are going to skyrocket. The number of those who are going to die is going to be tremendous. Be prepared for a terrible week. And I thought, well, what happened to last week? Last week and this week were supposed to be the very worst of the worst, man. But last week, it came and it went, and then this week what they're saying is that no, this week is going to be the worst one. This week is going to be the worst one. Man, the fear of death, it should be something that we take to heart, man, that we prepare for, that we're conscious of every single day. When we look in the scripture, it says to test yourself daily to make sure that you remain in the faith. It says every morning when I get up, man, test myself. Am I still in the faith? Because if I'm not, then I'm lost. If I am, then I'm good. Jesus, he tells a story about a man who was very wealthy. He was very rich, and he comes outside one day and he looks around and he sees all of these barns that he's built. And he thinks, man, look how great I've got it. Look how wonderful things are for me. He says, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to tear all of this stuff down and I'm going to rebuild bigger and stronger, more barns, bigger and more storage areas so I can store up for myself even more wealth. And the Lord tells him, he says, you fool. You fool, this very day you will die. Let me be completely honest with you, brothers and sisters, that every single day that we leave the house, man, we could have an aneurysm, a silent aneurysm, that the moment that it burst, we hit the floor dead. We could have a heart attack like a friend of mine did not long ago, man, when he's walking up to a desk and work, hits the ground, dead. Or we could die in an automobile accident where we're traveling down the interstate and out of the blue, before we even realize it, man, there's a car traveling in the wrong direction and it smashes us, hits us, and we're dead. Death happens every single day, and COVID-19 did not invent death, and COVID-19 has not caused death, and COVID-19 has not changed death. Death is a reality that we face every single day, and we could not get COVID-19 and we could still die of something else. And that's why the Word of God says that we are to test ourselves daily to make sure that we remain in the faith so that we do not die. Because for the believer, there is no death. There is only passing from this world into the presence of our Savior. And as far as being anxious, for the believer, we're called not to be anxious, but to rest in our faith, to rest in the assurance of our faith. So this morning I wake up, and what I do is I ask myself the question, is Jesus the chief end of my day? Is everything that I do, am I doing it for Jesus? Am I remaining in the faith? Do I have the faith that I had when I first began? Am I contending for the faith? Am I battling for the faith? Am I fighting for my faith? And that is to cling on to the man named Jesus Christ. And if I am, then there's no fear for me because there's no death for me. There could be an accident. There could be a heart attack. There could be an aneurysm. There could be a sudden diagnosis of pancreatic cancer. And in 4 days, I could be dead when I'm healthy right now. Or I could get the flu. Or I could get COVID-19. But if I'm in the faith, there's no death for me. There's only standing before my Savior and seeing Him for how He truly is. For the Word of God says that when that day comes, we will know Him even as we are known. That right now we look at Jesus as through a mirror dimly lit. We can't get a grasp on who He truly is in all of the fullness of His glory. But when we die, we will know Him as He truly is. We will be standing in glory. There will be no sickness. There will be no death. There will be no sadness. There will be no mourning. There will only be us and Jesus for all eternity. So what do I do with anxiety? What do I do with anxiety if I'm a believer and I'm sure that I'm contending for the faith and I'm sure that I'm saved? What do I do? Man, I go into the Word of God and I read what it says. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 25 and on, listen to these words from our Savior. Therefore, I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. And is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds. You hear them chirping behind me. It says, look at the birds in the air. Neither do they sow nor reap nor gather in barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not more valuable than they? And which of you, by being anxious, can add a single hour to your lifespan? Which of you, by being anxious, can add a single hour to your lifespan? Put on your gloves and your Tyvek suit and your mask and you still die of something else. Man, you need Jesus not to be safe. You do need to be safe, but you need Jesus. That's what the fear is. That's what the anxiety is. You need Jesus Christ. It says, and are you anxious about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. Neither did they toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all of his glory was not arrayed as one of these. But if God so clothes the grass in the field, which today is alive and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, believer? Will he not clothe you, saint? Will he not clothe you, Christian? Remove your anxiety and put on faith. That's what the Word of God is telling us. Trust in your Savior. Surrender to Him. Fall into His arms. Or, oh, you little faith, therefore do not be anxious, saying, what shall I eat, or what shall I drink, or what shall I wear? For the Gentiles seek after these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them all. But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all of these things will be added to you. Verse 34 says, therefore do not be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious about itself. Sufficient is this day and its own troubles. So when you turn on the news and you hear that this week is going to be worse than last week, put on the faith and make sure that you remain. Make sure that you're contending. Make sure that you're saved, and then relax in the fact that for the believer, there is no death. There's only passing from not knowing God fully to knowing God fully. You gain in the kingdom of heaven. You don't lose. The Word of God is where we need to go, not CNN or NBC or ABC or Fox News or anywhere else. It's the Word of God. That's the only place we need to go. And on a side note, last week they told us the next 2 weeks are going to be the worst weeks that we've ever seen in our life. This week, they tell us next week will be the worst week we've ever seen in our life. And in the same 20 minutes, they said that the death rates in New York are dropping and that the discharge rates are increasing. It seems people are getting better, even though they're telling us that things are going to get worse. The media has always driven fear. It has always driven anxiety, so that we'll be scared out of our minds and we'll depend on the government to protect us. But it's not the government that we get salvation from. It's the man named Jesus. And we only get salvation through Him by remaining in the faith, by continuing in the faith, by fighting for the faith. And every morning when we wake up, we ask ourselves, am I divided? Like Elijah said, don't sway to the right or to the left, man, but choose this day who you will serve.